नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एलिमिनेशन ऑफ एम्बिग्युइटी. ओके, सो ऑल द एम्बिग्युइटी आर नॉट पॉसिबल टू एलिमिनेट, बट फ्यू ऑफ द एम्बिग्युइटी कैन बी एलिमिनेटेड. ओके, सो फॉर मोस्ट पार्सर द ग्रामर मस्ट बी अनएम्बिगुअस. सो इन पार्सिंग यू विल फाइंड द वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट द ग्रामर यू आर यूजिंग must be unambiguous. It must be unambiguous. Okay, unambiguous grammar means unique selection of parse tree for a sentence. Okay? Every time you will give a sentence, it will give you a unique parse tree. Okay, so we should eliminate the ambiguity in grammar during the design phase of the compiler. An unambiguous grammar should be written into written to eliminate the ambiguity. So if you have an unambiguous grammar, you can just try to rewrite it by eliminating the ambiguities, and you can have a corresponding non-ambiguous grammar or unambiguous grammar. Okay, we have to prefer one of the parse tree of a sentence generated by an ambiguous grammar to disambiguate the grammar, to restrict this to the choice. You understand? So you know what is ambiguity? The grammar generates multiple derivation trees. Now if you prefer a particular derivation tree out of them, and based on that if you modify the grammar so that the grammar will always generate that particular type of derivation tree. So, keeping that in mind, you can rewrite the grammar. Okay. Now, Dagling's problem is one of the example. If you see statement, if expression, then another statement, or if expression, then statement, else statement, or some other thing. Okay. If the expression are given by U1 and statements are given by expressions given by E and statement by S. Okay, so the same thing is rewritten in a shorter form. And when you will generate parse tree, it will give a parse tree like this. Okay. Now, problem is that you can have multiple parse tree for the same thing. You can say if E1, if E2, if E1, if E2. Then S1, then S1, else S2, else S2. Okay, so this Dagling's problem is an ambiguity problem. Okay, so we prefer the second parse tree in this case. Okay, this parse tree we prefer. We have to disambiguate our grammar to reflect this choice. So we have to rewrite basically this grammar so that every time our grammar generate this kind of parse tree. Okay. So the unambiguous grammar will be in this case if we rewrite statement to matched statement and unmatched statement. Okay. So previously it was statement equal to this or this, but here we generate, we are adding two non-terminals here. Okay, match statement and unmatch statement. Now match statement equal to if expression then match statement, else match statement or other statement, and unmatch statement equal to if expression then statement, or if expression then match statement, else unmatch statement. So in this way, if we rewrite the grammar, we can have a unambiguous grammar corresponding to that. Okay. So here, if you see, this is arrow sign. Okay. We have a grammar. From the beginning of our discussion, we are seeing that this is a ambiguous grammar. Correct. Just a minute. Okay, so what is saying that ambiguous grammar, because ambiguous operators can be disambiguous according to precedence and associativity rule. If they are, definitely it is possible only when you have a grammar which is dealing with arithmetic rules, like plus minus, like here you can see. Okay, so if you see this, here we have a grammar e to e plus e in multiplication e, e to the power e id in bracket e, and we know that precedence of this three operation, here you can have, you can see plus, multiplication, and to the power are different, right? So if you want to disambiguate this grammar, first you have to look at the precedence. Precedence are, if you see, to the power having a precedence is right to left, right? But if you look at multiplication and addition, they are left to right. Okay, so we have to handle it in such way, we have to rewrite it in such way that this right to left thing can take place fast, and definitely this to the power is already having higher precedence than the other two. Okay, so it can be rewrite like this. You can see here e to e plus t, or t to t multiplication f or f to g to the f or g to id or in bracket e. Now you can see that all the expression or string can be generated by the string, by this generator, are also possible to generate by this grammar. So both the grammar are having same language right now, but this is unambiguous and this is ambiguous. Okay, so a grammar is okay. Now come to left recursion. I had told you about left recursion at the beginning itself. So a grammar is left recursive if it has non-terminal a, such that there is a production, that there is a derivation a. After a few derivation step, one or more derivation step, it is again coming back to A alpha. Okay, so in one or more derivation step, if this is happening, then you will say that there is left recursion. So top-down parsing techniques cannot handle left recursive grammar. So if you are using top-down parsing technique, then left recursion have to be removed, otherwise this grammar will not be useful. So we have to convert our left recursive grammar into an equivalent grammar which is not left recursive. Okay, and the left recursion may appear in single step of the derivation, like in immediate left recursion, or may appear in more than one step of the derivation. So understand, so you can have a rule like this, a to a alpha, so immediately you will find the left recursion. But you can have something like this, a to b alpha, then you can have b to a beta, then what will happen, you will have derivation like a to, sorry, derivation we write like this, a to b alpha, which will then give you this b replaced by a beta, right? This, so this is another way you can get, or you can face left recursion. Okay, immediate left recursion, if you see at this, if you have a grammar rule like this, I have already told you, and we call it immediate left recursion. But how we can eliminate this? We can eliminate this only if we have the rules in this form. That means a to a alpha or a to beta. Means you have to have two rules. Then we can remove it. A to a alpha and a to beta. Now, most of the cases you will have these two rules, because if A is a useful alpha, non-terminal, then A must lead you to some terminal symbol. So when if it is good grammar, you will most of the time you will find this part. Okay. Now it is saying that if you have your production rule in with a left recursion, immediate left recursion in your grammar, then we can rewrite it like A to beta A dash, a new variable came here, and A dash to alpha A dash or epsilon. Okay, so now here you can see one thing happened, that it was immediate, the leftmost position was taking this head variable, but here it is just shifted on the other side of alpha. Okay, so this is how you can rewrite as left recursive grammar by removing left recursion. Okay, so let me rewrite and let me show you where is the left recursion. So if I take the first rule, it is written like this: E to E plus T or T. So you can see that left recursion is there due to this E arriving here at the beginning. Okay. At the same time, we can compare this rule to this production rule. So this can be compared with alpha, this can be compared with beta, and E can be compared with A, this E can be compared with A. If this is the situation, then definitely we can rewrite it like this. So when you will rewrite, it will become what? E to beta is here T, E dash, then E dash to alpha here is plus T, okay, then E dash or epsilon. So the first rule is rewritten as this. The second rule is this one. Here we have left recursion due to this T arising at the first position of its body. So again, this star F can be compared with alpha, and this F can be compared with beta, and we can rewrite it like this: T to beta is F here, F T dash, and then T dash to here alpha is star F T dash or epsilon. Okay, so we got another two production rule, and other two are as it is. So F to ID does not have any left recursion, and another we have F to in bracket E does not have any left recursion. So this grammar has been written like this by removing left recursion. Okay, so I am ending this discussion here today. You don't have enough student also. Yash, please take care of this.